Hi children, welcome to your next lecture of mathematics. Today we are moving towards the next lesson of mathematics, that is operation on fractions. We have already learned some basics about fractions. Let's revise all this one by one in this lesson and move towards the next part of this lesson, that is to add, to convert, to subtract and many more. So let us head towards some examples. Now I am giving some examples like 1 upon 4, 5 upon 8, 12 upon 5, and 9 upon 11, 17 upon 8. Now, when you look at these fractions, as we all know, the upper part is called numerator and the bottom part is called the denominators. Now, in these fractions, what is the difference between some? Let me guess. Fractions like 1.4, 5 upon 8, 1 upon 4, 5 upon 8 and 9 upon 11. These three fractions have their numerators less than the denominators. Let me write it below. 1 upon 4, 1 is less than 4. Next, 5 upon 8, 5 is less than 8. Next, 9 upon 11, 9 is less than 11. So here all the numerators are less than the denominators. Now the fractions whose numerator are less than the denominators are called as proper fractions. Got it? Any fraction whose numerator is less than the denominators is called as proper fractions. Now, coming to rest of the examples, like I have 12 upon 5 and 17 upon 8 left. Now, what is the difference that you see? It's just opposite of the above example, that the numerators are greater than the denominators. Now, the fractions whose numerators are greater than the denominators are called as improper fractions. Got it? Any fraction whose numerator is greater than improper fraction, whose numerator is smaller is called as proper fraction. Now, let us come to some more examples apart from these. Let us see to that. Now, I would take numbers like 10, 1 upon 2, 10 and 1 upon 2. Next, I would take 11 and 3 upon 4. 7 and 5 upon 7. Now, when you look at these fractions, like you have a number and a fraction, again a number and a fraction, again a number and a fraction. So, these fractions are neither proper nor improper, but these are called as mixed fractions. Why mixed fractions? I'll tell you the reason. Now, we have a number before every fraction, okay? See, again here, 1 is less than 2, 3 is less than 4, 5 is less than 7. So, that means these fractions are proper fractions. Now, the numbers 10, 11 and 7, what are they? We have learnt in our last chapter that such numbers are nothing but integers. So, the integral number and a fraction together is called as mixed fraction. What is mixed fraction? An integral number and a fraction with it is called as mixed fraction. Let it be pure or improper, but still, if the fraction has an integer with it, an integral number and a fraction together when it comes is called as mixed fractions. I guess all my students have understood the basics. This we have already learnt in your previous standards, but it was just a revision for you. What is proper, what is improper, and mixed fractions. Now, what we will learn in this chapter is to convert the fractions. So, in this chapter, we do not have any question related to proper fractions. We are only going to learn about improper fraction and mixed fractions, because proper fraction there is nothing to convert. It's because it's less than the denominator, so we can't divide or do anything with it. Only thing we can change is in the improper fraction and the mixed fraction. So we will head towards that topic. Let's learn one by one. If you have any doubt, children, you can just put up the questions in the comment box or ask me your doubts during the sessions, so that you'll get cleared with your concepts about the fractions. Now, coming to the next topic, that is conversion of improper fraction into mixed fraction. Now, as you all know, what is improper fraction? A fraction whose numerator is greater than the denominator. And what is mixed fraction? A fraction which has an integer, that is integral number, and a fraction with it together is called as mixed fraction. Okay. Now, we have to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. So, for that we need to take some example. Suppose I am taking an example with a statement. If I have 3 apples. Okay. Now, if 3 apples are to be divided, equally between 2 children, how many will each one get? Now, there are how many apples together? We have 3 apples altogether. Now, how it is to be divided? It is to be divided equally. Now, what is equally? Suppose you are having a sister with you. Okay, your father is bringing 2 chocolates. Now, mother is saying divide it equally among the children. What will your father do? He has only 2 chocolates. And equally means it should be same with both of them. So, he will divide the 2 chocolates into 1 and 1. Like you will get 1 and your sister will get 1. That means it is equal proportion. That means 1 is to 1. Now, similarly, here also I have 3 apples with me. Now, I have to divide it equally. That means both the children should get equal part of it. Into 2 children, how much will each get? When we say divided equally, it is understood that we have to divide the numbers. So, we will divide 3 and 2. Like 2 is divided, like 3 is divided from 2. 2 is our divisor and 3 is our dividend. How we will divide? Okay, now in this we have a remainder also. Now, remainder, this is our quotient. This is our remainder. This is our dividend. And this is our divisor. Now, how to write this particular answer in mixed fraction? How to write? We have to write it in the form of 1, 1 by 2. Now, what is this 1, 1 by 2? This 1 is your quotient. This 1 is your remainder. And this 2 is your divisor. So, how to write an improper fraction into mixed fraction? We have to divide it. We will get a remainder, quotient, dividend and all. How to convert, how to write it properly? The quotient will be our integral number, that is integer. Quotient will be our integer. And the numerator will be our remainder. And the divisor will be our denominator. Now, when we write this in improper fraction, it is written as this way, 3 upon 2. Now, how to read this? We have to read this as 1 and 1 upon 2. Got it? How to write it? Understood very well. So, shall we move to the next question? Yes. So, now next question we will have without a word problem. We will just try to solve it as an example. Now, you have a question here where 7 upon 2 is given. So, 7 is greater than 2. That means any numerator which is greater than denominator is called as improper fraction. So, we have to convert improper into mixed fraction. What we had done earlier, we have to divide it. So, 7 is divided from 2. So, how we will write it? 7 inside and 2 is our divisor. So, 2 threes are 6. 7 minus 6, 1. Now, how to write this in mixed fraction? We will first write our integral number as 3, the remainder as numerator and divisor as a denominator. So, children, make it noted that improper fraction, we have numerator is bigger than denominator. But when we write it in mixed fraction, it is in the proper fraction form where the numerator is less than denominator. So, whenever you are solving, keep this in mind. The question of improper fraction will be in such a way where the numerator is greater. But when we convert, we will not get improper fraction here. We will get it as proper fraction. Got it? Understood? Very well done. Have understood the concept well. What is improper? What is mixed? How to convert improper into mixed and all? Shall we head towards our problem set so that we can practice some more questions and understand the concept better? Okay. So, moving to your practice set here. I have the first question in your practice set where you have to convert the improper fraction into mixed fractions. Question number 1 of your problem set 9. Convert into mixed fractions. Now, the first question in that is 30 divided by 7. Now, how to convert? We all know to convert we have to divide. So, 30 divided by 7, I will write it as 7 fours are 28. I get remainder as 2. So, when I write it into mixed fraction, I will write it as 4 2 upon 7. So, when 30 upon 7 is converted into mixed fraction, I get it as 4 2 upon 7. Now, the second question I have here is 7 upon 4. I will write it as 7 divided by 4. That is 7 inside and 4 outside. 4 ones are 4. I have remainder 3. So, when I write the improper fraction 7 into mixed fraction, I got the answer as 1 and 3 upon 4. Next. I have a question as 15 upon 12. I have to divide it. So, while dividing, 12 ones are 12, I got a remainder as 3. When I convert this 15 upon 12 into mixed fraction, I get 1 and 3 upon 12. Okay. Now, next, I have 11 upon 8, which is written as 11 divided by 8. I will divide it now. 8 ones are 8. 3 I'll get here as the answer. So when I write this into mixed fraction, I will get 1 and 3 upon 8. So likewise, please try to solve questions. These two is for practice for yourself. Try to solve these four questions and try to get the answers of these two questions by your own, so that you will understand how to do it by your own. Okay. So coming to next question, where we have to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Till now you all have learned how to convert into mixed fraction, hence I took the question of mixed fraction first. Now I'll take up the question of mixed into improper fraction. So convert into improper fraction. Now here I have the first question as 7, 2 upon 5. Okay. Now here I have two methods to solve this question. Two methods to solve from mixed to improper. We'll learn method 1. In method 1, what I'll do is, I said 7 and 2 upon 5, that means 7 plus 2 upon 5. Please understand this. If I say and, it is always plus. So 7 plus 2 upon 5. Now here I have a numerator and denominator. But with 7, do I have a denominator? No. So it is understood, if a number is there alone, it is having a denominator 1. Now, in 1's table, we'll get 5. 5 1's are 5 and 1 5's are 5. So, if it is 1 into 5 is 5, we get the answer 5. If I multiply 5 in the denominator, by rule, we have to multiply 5 in the numerator also. So, 7 into 5 upon 1 into 5. Here, there is no change because 5 is the greater number and we are making this side equal to 5. So, 2 upon 5. 7 5's are 35, 1 5's are 5 and 2 upon 5. So, I got both the denominators same, 5 and 5. I will write 5 one side together. 35 plus 2, that is 37 upon 5. I guess you all understood how to solve it. Method 2, now I'll go. Again the same question, 7 2 upon 5 is the question. How to do it here? I will multiply the denominator and add the numerator. I will multiply this integral number with the denominator and add it with numerator. Now how to do it? 7 into 5 plus 2 upon 5. What I did? Integral number is multiplied with denominator and added with the numerator. And again denominator is written as it is. Because it is fraction, we have to find a fraction. So we have to write the denominator also. So 7 into 5 is 35 plus 2 upon 5. We got the answer as 37 upon 5. So when you check both the methods, answers are same. So it is easy now. When you do any method, you can just check your answer with the other method where you can find the answer as same. Okay, understood? So shall we head towards the next example to understand the concept much better? Now, I'll take up the question, second question from your textbook. That is 5, 1 upon 6. So this is the question now. I have to convert it. Again, I'll do both the methods for you. Method 1, where 5 is added with the fraction 1 upon 6. So, I have no denominator with 5, I'll put 1. 1 into 6 is 6, 6 into 1 is 6. So, I'll multiply only this side as I have the denominator over there as the highest. So, 5 into 6, as by rule, we have to multiply a particular number to make it common or same denominators. In the numerator and denominator, we have to multiply the number equally. Like if I multiply 1 into 5, again in the numerator also I have to multiply with 5. If I multiply any number in the denominator as 2, 3, I have to multiply the same number in the
numerator also. So here I am multiplying 1 into 6. So in the numerator also I will multiply 5 into 6. So 5 6 are 30, 1 6 are 6. So 30 plus 1 upon 6, I got the answer as 31 upon 6. Now we'll check with the second method. It is 5, 1 upon 6. So how we will do? Multiply with denominator and add with the numerator and write the denominator as it is. So 5, 6 are 30 plus 1 upon 6. 30 plus 1 is 31 upon 6. So I got the answer easily. Now children, please note that you can solve any method. It's not compulsory that you have to solve both the methods for exam. They may not ask you. They may just say convert into improper fraction and numbers will be given. So you have to take up any method which you find easy and you can solve it as per your wish. Okay, you can take up method 1 or you can take up method 2. Whichever you find easy to calculate or easy to do, we can do it. So I guess you all understood how to solve, how to convert into improper fractions. So there is 3 more questions which you will be solving as for homework. Any doubts, you can please put up the doubts in the comment section or ask me during the sessions. Like you have 4, 3 upon 4. Fourth question, you have 2, 5 upon 9. And fifth question, you have 1, 5 upon 7. So 3 questions you have for homework. So you can solve it very fast. It's not that tough. And while solving in the homework also, need not do both methods. You can take up any method and do any one method. Okay. Only for teaching purpose, I have taken both the methods. But you can solve by any one method. Okay, keep it in mind. We'll move towards your practice set question number 3, where a word problem is given, and in this you have to just write it in the form of fractions. So let us see to that. Now coming to the topic, if 9 kgs of rice is shared among 5 people, how many kilograms of rice does each person get? Now how many kilos of rice? 9 kilos is to be shared among 5 per people. Now what you will do? We have to find how much each person will get. Now each person will get 9 upon 5 kilos of rice. Now it is an improper fraction. We cannot write it like this. We have to write in mixed fraction. That means we have to convert it. So therefore 9 upon 5 equals to 9 divided by 5 equals to 5 ones are 5. So 9 minus 5 is 4. Now how much will each person get? Each person will get 1 and 4 upon 5 kilos of rice. Understood the concept? Again, here you had given the question. They gave you improper fractions, which is understood that you have to anyhow convert it into mixed fraction. So as it is improper fraction with numerator as greater than denominator, we have to convert it into mixed fraction to find the actual kilos of rice that is to be shared among each person. Okay. Now you have one more question. In the same way, where 5 shirts are to be made from 11 meters of cloth. 5 shirts are to be made among 11 meters of cloth. Now, how much cloth is needed for one shirt? They are given you lump sum that total they have to make 5 shirts, and they are asking you how much will one shirt take? How much meters cloth will one shirt take? It's understood that when we have to make 5 shirts and only 11 meters of cloth is provided for one shirt, how much meters of cloth is required? Now how you will solve this? Again, for 5 shirts we have 11 meters cloth. For one shirt we have 11 upon 5 meters cloth. So 11.5, it is improper fraction. It is understood that we have to convert it into mixed fraction. So 11 upon 5 means 11 divided by 5. So 11 is divided by 5. So 5 twos are 10. I get a remainder 1. So when remainder is 1, what is my mixed fraction? 2, 1 upon 5. 2 and 1 upon 5. So each person will, each cloth requires 2 and 1 upon 5 meters. Each shirt requires 2 and 1 upon 5 meters cloth. So each shirt requires 2 and 1 upon 5 meters cloth. So I guess you all understood in this video that what is proper fraction, what is improper fraction, what is mixed fraction, how to convert improper into mixed, where mixed will be having an integer number, integral number and a proper fraction with it. How to vice versa, that is mixed fraction into improper fractions. And we had also solved some word problems from your problem set. And we had some more examples also. I guess you all understood the topic well. Thank you.